Okay. Well, welcome back, Christian. So, at this point in the series of classes, we've had several where we've practiced the breathing techniques, observing the breath, and employing the Hum Sa mantra. So at this point, are you feeling comfortable with all of those techniques?
Yes.
In meditation? Great. So today what I'd like to do is introduce the idea of using affirmations to supplement, incorporate into our meditation, and how to do it effectively, and why we would want to do it at all. Mm-hmm. So as we think about the word affirmation, how might you define
that? Sure. Affirmation to me is a statement or idea that helps guide you or gives you a goal or motivates you, gets you is where you want to be.
Okay, that's excellent. Yeah, great. I referenced the Webster's Dictionary version of the definition of affirmation, and it defines it as the act of affirming or a positive assertion. So, with your statement and that definition, that tells me that it's not passive, but rather requires action. And for the purposes of using affirmations with meditation, I would take it a step further and say that an affirmation is a statement of a higher truth about ourselves or the world. To share a quote with you that I thought was rather important, the late Swami Kriyananda from the Ananda Center said that words are thoughts crystallized. So words are thoughts crystallized. That has a lot of power behind that statement. And what that means to me is that our words have power. And therefore, they should be very carefully chosen so that ideas about ourselves are deliberately cultivated. So, a little bit about what affirmation is and is not. Affirmation is not wishful thinking. Affirmation is a tool, rather, that we can use to help remove limiting beliefs or ideas from our subconscious mind. Research shows that anything that we do repeatedly actually changes our brain structure and function. So with practice, we can use this tool to help remove unwanted or undesirable or limiting beliefs and replace them with something positive and expansive. So, in regards to affirmation with meditation, I want to touch on three main points today, and that is habits of thought, the three levels of consciousness, and then how we can use affirmations to willfully change our levels of consciousness. So, starting with habits of thought, habits of thought are stored in our subconscious mind. They are the messages that we repeat to ourselves throughout the day, for instance, either aloud, consciously, or just mentally to ourselves. One example might be, I'm good at my job, which could be a positive affirmation, or I'm not good at making friends. So the habits of thought are, like I mentioned, stored in the subconscious mind. They can become our default, as it were, sense of self. Now that I've mentioned subconscious and conscious mind, let me explain a bit about the three levels of consciousness. So there is the subconscious, the conscious mind, and the superconscious mind. And so another way to relate to that is that these are levels of awareness.
Okay.
So the subconscious mind is an enormous part of our consciousness. And it's good to be aware of that, because that is where our memories and our emotions, our habits, our thoughts are all stored. And the conscious mind feeds the subconscious. So the subconscious mind is operated at the base of the brain in the back. Mm-hmm. And over time, this becomes a place where these ideas of self are rooted. Our likes and our dislikes, our desires, everything that we're responding to that we make conclusions about are stored in the subconscious. The subconscious mind is active when we're sleeping. It's also active when we're awake and alert. The conscious mind is when we are in, as we are now, sort of an awakened state. Mm. The conscious mind is responsible for taking in all the external stimuli through the senses, processing it, organizing it, making conclusions, and then storing some of that information in the subconscious mind. The conscious mind is operated in the midbrain. Here. Then we have the superconscious mind. And this is where, if you've ever felt when you're really thoroughly engaged in an activity, you feel like you would say you're in the zone.
Right.
That's the superconscious mind in operation. It's the seat of our experience of creativity and joy and calm and intuition and inspiration. And that's all operated in the front, in the prefrontal lobes of the brain. So within these three levels of consciousness, being aware of those, we can begin to understand where our thoughts are coming from. Are they a default thought that has been ingrained over time that's being pulled from the subconscious mind?
Mm-hmm.
Or is it a higher truth? Can we intentionally create ideas and conclusions about ourselves? So knowing a bit about these three levels of consciousness, we can then go on to talk about how can we change willfully our level of consciousness. So with affirmations, again, it's a tool. It's a tool for removing or changing undesirable thoughts or habits. When we use an affirmation to do that, we want to do it with high energy and conviction. Because the mind has a tendency to reject new ideas mm-hmm. that aren't consistent with perhaps the self-image that we've developed over time through default experience. So instead, we're going to actively and deliberately connect with the superconscious mind in the prefrontal lobes, where we can change our brain structure, create new pathways that hold and solidify these new and potentially improved ideas about ourselves. So there has to be the willingness to reject the mind saying, no, that isn't so, or that doesn't sound like truth to me. With practice and time, we can replace habits and thoughts more quickly than it took to establish them in the first place.
Okay.
We also want to affirm with a sense of it's already a reality. It's already done. You know, we make declarative statements, I am, I do, I have, rather than I hope to or I might. You know, it wants to be affirming as though it was already a reality.
Right.
Because the brain doesn't actually understand the difference between this new inner reality and the existing external reality. So we're going to move into a practice. We'll do a brief practice, including the breathing techniques, watching the breath, employing the mantra. We're also going to begin with an affirmation. And so I will repeat an affirmation, and you'll repeat along with me after I share the affirmation. You'll then repeat it aloud, then with energy and conviction.
Right.
Then we'll repeat it a little softer, and then just a whisper, and then only mentally.
Okay.
Then we'll move into the Hong Sa portion of the practice.
Okay.
So, for example, if a person was feeling worrisome and insecure, this affirmation may be of help. I am strong in myself. I am complete in myself. The joy and perfection of the universe await discovery within my inner being. So that's what we'll practice today.
Okay.
So let's come into our posture for prepare for meditation. You want to make sure that your hips are slightly elevated above your knees, which they are. Back straight, spine erect, and shoulders back. Lifting the chest. Remember to keep your head centered above your torso and your chin level with the floor. So we'll begin with the breathing exercise, which is equal count breathing.
Okay.
So if you'd like to close your eyes, and remember to lift your gaze above to the point between the eyebrows. And we'll begin by inhaling to a count of four. One, two, three, four. Hold, two, three, four. Exhale, three, four. Inhale, two, three, four. Hold, two, three, four. Exhale. Last round, inhale, three, four, hold, exhale. Now you can take one regular inhalation and exhalation and let go of the breath completely. You want to just lower your head so your chin's a little more level with the floor. There you go. Keeping your gaze uplifted. Letting go of the breath, and repeat after me, with energy and conviction, as though you believe it, I am strong in myself.
I am strong in myself.
I am complete in myself.
I am complete in myself.
The joy and perfection of the universe.
The joy and perfection of the universe.
Await discovery within my inner being.
Await discovery within my inner being.
A little softer. I am strong in myself.
I am strong in myself.
I am complete in myself.
I am complete in myself.
The joy and perfection of the universe.
The joy and perfection of the universe.
Await discovery within my inner being.
Await discovery within my inner being.
Now just a whisper. I am strong. In myself. The joy and perfection of the universe await discovery within my inner being. Now you can release the affirmation and without controlling the breath, simply becoming an observer of it. Inhale through the nose, exhale. Focus on the breath in the nostrils where you feel the breath most easily. If the mind wanders, just bring it back to the breath. Again, just observing the breath, not controlling it. Allow you to breathe in and out naturally. If the breath slows or becomes shallow, inhalation, mentally repeat the mantra Hong, and repeat mentally only Sa as you exhale. index finger, slightly curling it towards the palm in the inhalation while repeating mentally "Hong," and extending it away from the palm slightly, mentally repeating "Sa." Continue with the Hong Song practice. Remembering to keep your gaze lifted and concentrated at the point between the eyebrows. your surroundings. And when you're ready, open your eyes. So, in conclusion, affirmations are a tool. They're a tool that we can use. They're a tool that we can use before our meditation, after our meditation. The goal is to connect with superconsciousness so that that can take control of establishing this new, expanded, higher truth in our subconscious. There are great times throughout the day when you could practice an affirmation, when you're in traffic or waiting in line somewhere, when you hear yourself repeating something negative. You can counter that idea with a positive affirmation. With practice, you can reestablish desirable beliefs in your daily life. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you.